I don't want to play Math Mech anymore.
Yeah. Why don't we all play Math Mech?
Let us never speak of Math Mech again.
Hello and welcome to the Cowboy for Game Yu-Gi-Oh! Podcast. I'm your host Jake. Today I'm joined by Ben from Northern TCG.
My neck was itchy.
And Bragg, any ailments for you?
I don't know. Got to get some vampires on the ladder, I reckon. Lay in there. Everyone forgets about them because the other cards in those sets were better, but vampires are good for neck itches, and that's it.
I do have a lot of spare vampire cards laying around. I could use them solely as scratching
Nexus.
I was so keen when they announced vampire support. I was like, oh, all this shit that I pulled from that garbage set that had the Sky Strikers will be worth anything. Nope.
So I opened 6 boxes of that set. I should have opened more in retrospect.
Actually, no, I ended up selling a deck to that dude in Nara for like far more than it should have.
I got 2 sealed boxes in my room.
Really?
It was like
investment, I guess.
It was like my second like date with Britt. Like we were doing some Pokemon Go shit, and I'm like, oh, I gotta crack this. I'm like, this is what I do. And I'm just in the thing going, vampire. Oh, I got 1 engage.
Oh, just 1.
Alright, this is what I do.
How was our week in Yu-Gi-Oh? Barring today.
Oh, today was good. Today was fine.
Today was good.
So
yeah, I'm just saying that we'll be discussing today in more depth, I imagine. So
I guess we can do that more depth.
Yeah, there's another day that
my Tuesday was fine. I went X1. I lost. I didn't lose the final. I lost before the final to Josh. But I took revenge today. Revenge is sweet.
It does feel nice.
So yeah, again, still playing Dragonmaids. Just kind of opened well all day. Like, I'm comfortable in the deck now that, like, it's very rare to lose to your own hand. Mm. You will lose to your opponent's hand. So, like, you can always put up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 disruptions. It just depends on your hand as to how many you put out. And it simply just comes down to whether or not your opponent can play through them. Today, at all times, I was able to play. We'll discuss this when we discuss the 1K. We call it the 1K because it was 1K in price support, I guess.
The Player of the Year.
Player of the Year. Whatever we're going to call it. So, Tuesday was decent. X1, Dragon Maids, still going good. Going fine and dandy. Bragg, how's your week in Yu-Gi-Oh?
I am now committed to at least 45 minutes of test hands a day.
Oh, I forgot. I played a lot of Master Duel.
Oh!
Runic.
Oh,
Runic is out. I played a lot
one
of
cringe deck was banned, so we moved on to another.
It's really good.
And how many ultras?
A lot of ultras. It is an expensive deck.
Okay.
It burned all those resources I was bragging about. I mean, like, I've got so many gems, I've got so many tickets, all gone.
What are you running it with?
Pure Runic. So Runic with its vanities, and they can only be one.
I could see myself getting on board with that.
You just go one into the other, flip them, and then just out-resource your opponent. That's it. I pretty much exclusively play against Labyrinth and Branded. Both matchups, not difficult at all.
No.
Even, like, the Burning Dragon is the only thing that gives you a little bit of trouble, and you can normally out it by paying, like, 3,600 or 800, however the market math works. It's good.
But yeah, so, test hands, at least 45 minutes a day. So I can see my... And even today, like, there's just players that I'm seeing, I'm like, oh, yay. I'm getting back in the fold. It's nice. Instead of just following the news.
Thinking about Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yeah. I'm back to thinking about Yu-Gi-Oh, which is not a play... Yeah, that's... It's that. It's like, it's one thing to read the news, stay across it, banter about it, and even play a few games. But to be, like, in there. It's good. It's good to be back. To be in.
Yeah. My Tuesday. Did I play on Monday? I feel like I had something on Monday. Maybe I did. I don't know. But anyway, Tuesday, I think I also went X1. I don't think I was in the finals.
You were not?
No. And again, just variance. It's the thing with mill decks is sometimes you don't mill well. But yeah, I suppose moving on from that, we can now discuss what happened today. So we did have our Wollongong Player of the Year tournament at Good Games. I think... The timing of it was not ideal, like in terms of when the points for qualification were, because that was about the time that Tier Element just started taking over everything and everyone's just like, no, I'm not interested, and heaps of people ducked out. So we didn't have our usual sort of numbers that we would have, like at those type of end of year stuff, we usually get around sort of 16-ish, like 12 to 16 people. But this year we only have the 8.
Yeah. Top 8 qualifiers.
Yeah, so we had 3 rounds of double Elim, moving on to a top 4 cut. And if you were watching us today at all, you would have seen this on stream, so I hope you enjoyed. So how was our experience in this?
Yeah. Congratulations to Luke first.
Oh, yes. Congratulations, Luke, for winning. Well done. Not with Tier Element as well, which almost needs an applaud in itself.
Sword Soul takes it down.
Yep, yeah. Ban Mogi.
It's just, Sword Soul pumping out the Omni Negate, the Monster Negate, the Blackout, and then it can play Bestials and not be punished. Like, it just has so much stuff there that, they're still good. Especially when you get in that limited format where then it can deal with those rogue picks like your Salads, your Math Mechs and all that.
Yeah.
It's also not running into the problem that it was when Branded was in the format, in that everyone was running D Barrier and they would just call Synchro, which would completely shut them down.
Hmm.
Where that's not a problem now because Tier Element fuse all the time, so D Barrier is really not going to help you. So that's a thing just in general for Sword Soul that's of a big benefit for them. And also, Sword Soul is one of the few decks that can actually compete in the current meta and still run a lot of hand traps. Generally speaking, you have to choose between one or the other in the current format. Solid performance. Deck's doing well. So, well done to Luke.
If you have the Baron, you got a deck. If you have the Baron.
If you have the Baron.
What's that now? It's
going to be somewhat cheaper, you would assume, being that the reprint's been announced.
Yeah, been announced. Been zoomed in on the leg of in a pack.
No,
video.
No. We talked about this.
Oh,
it was announced.
My bad. So, my 20 today. I did not make top 4. I unfortunately lost in the double Elim.
Mm-hmm.
I won my first game to Josh. Got my revenge for Tuesday. that one was on stream. I felt as though it was a good back and forth match. Other people said that Josh was playing slowly, but at the end of the day, it only punished himself. Because he put himself in the position where it was my turn, I had full control of the ability to add his board, and there was a minute left. And I was like, I guess I just break your board, do a little bit of damage game.
I don't know why, because I was sitting behind him, I was looking at the hand.
Yep.
It shouldn't have taken as long for him to work out the interaction as he took. And being that, having seen your hand post-game as well, within that interaction, it also didn't matter at all.
Yeah, I was always going to disrupt him the moment he started to try and interrupt me on my turn. I was happy to let him play on his turn. I interrupted him a little bit just to make sure I resolved a Magnet Search so that I had the other two Bestials in hand. I also, that was an attempt at forcing a Bestial out of his hand, because I knew if he didn't have a Bestial in his hand, I had game.
Yeah.
So, it was just a simple wait until the next turn. He did have one Bestial in his hand, but when he flipped Super Factorial, targeted his 3, I went, Bestial target your one that gives the negate. And then he was like, chain my Bestial targeting itself, and then I chained my second Bestial and targeted it, and then it was game over at that point.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that was that game.
That was your match against Josh.
Game round 2, I played against Leonardo. In game 1, I miss a very key interaction, which takes me from having 5 disruptions to having 1 disruption. And I was like, this sucks. If you have one Bestial in your hand, I lose. So I lost that game. Game 2, we each opened like decent and having a little bit of back and forth. And then he... mills 5, I think he uses the electric helicon one. We each mill 5, he mills like decent and I mill terribly, and I'm just like, if I just see one playable thing in my mills, I'm good. Instead I milled 5 Bestials and I'm like, that's not gonna cut it. I need to be able to disrupt his mills, because he milled a bunch of his Shizu stuff which could then interrupt the very few resources that I had.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh well, lost here. And then my round 3, I played against Andrew.
Hmm.
Game 1, I gambled on him not hard opening the Barry statue, he hard opened the barrier statue. And then game two, he opened Shifter, and my hand, I opened literally the five cards that say, you can play, but if he has a barrier statue, you lose. And he hard opened the barrier statue again. And I was like, okay.
Because you even had him on the back foot for 2 seconds off the fusion.
Yeah.
Like, he definitely was, like, sitting on that for a bit going.
Yeah.
You put him in a spot, but yeah. Bad statue.
Yeah, once the barrier statue was just dropped out of his hand, I was like, literally, my out is now banished. Because I opened, like, the fusion spell, both wins. Win little dragon, win big dragon. Then,
He dropped the shifter on the activation fusion, yeah.
Sorry. He just dropped the shifter in stem phase, and I was like, because if you didn't, I had fucking, I would have had more plays, because I had my other cards in hand were the branded spell card and Herald. So if he doesn't have shifter there, I'm going like fucking ham. And instead, he had it, and it is what it is. However,
so yeah, you didn't make it to top four, but
I won the event from my entry packs again. Big shout outs to Jabe, really came in clutch with like some really good price support for the top eight. I got a mega tin, half a booster box of Battles of Legend. Maybe it was 10 packs, almost half a booster box. So mega tin, that 2 OTS packs. Power of the Elements pack and 2 Valiance set packs.
Tama.
That one. Tactical Masters,
yeah.
And I pulled an ulti piece of shit, Water Enchantress. And the Starlight Rare Right Arm of Exodia.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
I won the event.
So I came in at the point where you'd obviously just opened one of the two and told you that the pizza was ready.
I opened the second.
Yeah, so you, like, said, yeah, okay, and then you said, don't ruin it.
Yeah, I said, don't ruin it.
And I hadn't seen anything, like, literally, I just poked my head in, I had my eyes, like, looking at you. And then I closed the door, and I was like, he's pulled something cracked, because otherwise he wouldn't have said that.
Yes.
Like, he's pulled bonkers. And then he comes out bonkers. And made a terrible joke.
It was a fantastic
joke. It was a fucking awful joke.
I think that joke was brilliant.
I liked it. Everyone was kind of distracted by the pizza to sell it, but I appreciate it.
I think it was the greatest joke in the history of mankind.
It was one of the worst things I've ever heard. Anyway, well done. Yeah, and then you commentate the rest of the day.
Yeah, me and Brad commentated till 4.
Yeah. So my day. So in round 1...
My favourite commentator I commentated with today.
Yeah, you didn't have much choice.
You had one other option.
Yeah, I know, that's what I mean. Round 1, I versus Leonardo. Game 1, I won the die roll, but opened almost completely unplayable. Like, one Havnus, double triple tactics. I think it was either Aegido or Kelbeck, one of the two, and something else.
That's like, fine if he opens an Aegido.
But that's the thing, I can't bait out his plays with the hand that I had. Like, it's one of the few things that I don't like about tactics, is that it burns a hole in your hand if you don't have an interactive play to make.
Yeah.
Like, because having seen the play afterwards, because he fucking demolished me in game 1, the tactics would have been live. Like, had I been able to play in, there would have been disruption. I would have been able to use it.
Yeah.
But there I was with nothing. Game 2, I kind of metagamed him because he likes to metagame me. So I thought he could go first. His mills were just not fantastic, and like, there was a bit of a trade back and forth, but like, there was definitely, it was more biased towards my plays than his. I did nearly stuff up really badly. So you know the rank 6 Wallow?
Yep.
The one that's like detach, reborn, yep. Blah 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 blah.
Yep.
I didn't remember about its first effect, the very first one that gives it attack.
Yeah.
And I went to attack into it and nearly died to it because I just didn't look properly.
Yeah.
Like, I got over it by 100. So it was close to being a monumental mistake. And then in game 3, again, Pete got to go first and was expecting to. And yeah, nils were not great. Game 2 was against... Round 2 was against Kotorka Salamangreat. Which was Grayson. That was not a particularly long match. So I had the Kelbeck? Yeah, I had Kelbeck. The Kelbeck for when he summoned the Heat Soul, because he summoned it with the Co-Talker.
Yep.
So then he had to burn a lot of resources to get that back on the board.
Okay, yep.
And then, like, I had the Shufflers. I had a lot of stuff going on.
In there, you had a mill. You did a mill five to him as well. And I think there was a spinning and stuff in there, but you're like, well, I don't care anymore.
Yeah, like, that was the thing. Like, oh, cool, I checked I'm the graveyard. Five, I was like,
no matter.
Yeah, like, that's the thing that's going to hurt those kinds of decks moving in. If you're not proactively doing stuff with the mills on the turn that they are milled, they're just going to get locked down.
Hmm.
That was something that came up in my game against Leonardo, where, like, my deck doesn't lose to an Abyss Dweller, but again, like, his mills were so much better than mine that an Abyss Dweller just shut down my ability to quick effect play around his stuff.
Yeah.
Made it tough.
Yeah. It's, yeah, it wasn't, like I said, it wasn't a particularly difficult match. I don't think we went to a game three. I think it was just a straight 2-0.
It was a straight 2-0.
Yeah.
That's where we milked a lot of the VOD. the replay. That's, yeah, we did get it running there. Yeah, what was your game after that?
My game after that was against Josh.
Yeah.
Oh, when Jake eliminated Josh from the tournament.
Yes, I did do that. That felt nice. So, again, the problem that Math Mech has is that it's a lot like Salad. A lot of its resources are in Grave. The worst thing about it, though, is that they're all Chaos typing. The ones that you actually want to summon are Dark or Light. Mainly Light. So, again, he goes for Super Factorial, Eye Chain, Abyssteel. I think he had an Apple Loser at that point as well. So I can't remember exactly what the plays were. I'm very terrible at remembering.
Yeah, him getting
plays.
That Apple Loser was also strange. He committed a few resources to that, which just seemed a bit over the shop. Yeah, he, by that point, he was kind of struggling.
It wasn't great for him. Like, the fact that he missed out on the summon back, just kind of put him in that negative position. And yeah, I was able to beat enough of the Appaloosa that it got down to a point where I could crash over it or beat over it. And then I think I still got to either Kikalos or Rukalos after that with Celiac set. So, and then yeah, game two, he just opened, like, I think he said double Lancia or something like that, which I found bizarre to even bother with citing those in. Like, it's a counterplay to a counterplay kind of thing, and I've never thought that that was a good idea. Like, because he's citing in Lancia so that my pistols can't then stop his thing.
Yeah. I've tested it. Like, I gave it a quick little go, but it harms more than does good.
That,
like,
it's must just have been his, like, this is my hot side deck card. Don't reveal it.
And yeah, like, I mean, it was so good because he was going on about it and he pushed just the three most basic bitch, like, texts in. And I'm like, oh, Joshua, you've done it again. Now, Lancia, I don't think Lancia is the play.
I don't think it's
100% understand the line of thinking, but probably should have.
The issue is that it's entirely predicated on your opponent opening certain interactions. I think in that game, it wasn't even the bestials that I was using to get rid of the stuff in the grave. I think it ended up being a Mudora. And I shuffle back all three targets.
Yeah.
Like, it just wasn't happening.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's one of those ones. I get it. I get why. If you're short on cards, sure. You put Lance in your side, but I don't think
I don't think today was the
place for it.
Yeah. So yeah, Josh was eliminated, which left us with the top four of myself, Luke, Andrew, and Leonardo. I got to face Leonardo again in the top four, and it went very much the same way.
Yeah, a team mirror in the final would have been interesting, but then also it just changed the whole complexion of everything. Like, yeah, the two tiers getting paired off, and then the Sword Soul that can kind of get around the Flunderies, muck around. Just that draw did kind of set up that path for Luke.
Yeah,
I mean, and Andrew missing a play.
Yeah, he missed a normal summon.
Yeah.
Like, it's the one thing that deck likes to do is once your opponent normal summons, and he just didn't.
The pressure didn't really seem to be there, and the day wasn't that long, but maybe the day was late, just because a couple people were missing key plays.
Sitting in the commentary room, it seemed tense through the door, because you could hear a pin drop.
Yeah. Yeah, there was like, there was a time.
I think
where
it was just that people appreciated the fact that this was obviously important, so they were keeping quiet.
Yeah.
Whereas usually when this kind of thing's going on, you've got some loud fucker in the background,
yeah,
and you have to like come over to him and be like, "Excuse me, shut the fuck up."
That's why I think doing it later was like, yeah,
yeah.
I think we're onto something.
Yeah, ooh. I actually also appreciated, and again, shout outs to Jake for this, that between the double Elim and the top four playoffs,
yeah,
that we had a pizza break.
Yeah, you put on Noah.
So that was nice.
It's good. It rewards. It's been a good year for Yu-Gi-Oh! In the end, and you look at that and go, "Hey, this is a tournament that capped off all the major decks that we saw at locals was there."
Yep.
And yeah, all the cool people were there, and yeah, pizza was had.
Hmm. So my pools weren't as cracked as Ben's, yeah, but I didn't do too badly. So I think I got 3 OTS, a bunch of Tactical Masters, bunch of Battles of Chaos, Mega Tin, I think that was it. Yeah.
That was it.
Oh, and some Power of the Element. And I think the highlight of mine was I got Dragoon from the Mega Tin, which not particularly expensive card, I don't think, but it was something I kind of needed since I sold my old one. And an ulti skill drain, which I haven't checked the price of. I'm assuming it's like $80 or something like that.
It's like 60.
I nearly pick them up for 60. But
I pulled an ulti skill drain as well.
That was Tuesday.
On Tuesday.
Yeah.
But there's too many good princess skill drain now that, like, I guess the market's just getting split up in that regard. That there's just too many princess. Like,
yeah,
because I like
the preference of high rarity.
The crappy shadow foil one. I kind of like that.
Turbo pack.
Yeah.
Turbo pack 8. Is it turbo pack 8? One of them.
Wait. Dual terminal as well.
Whichever ultra rare.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, there's a few options for that, so I guess that's why the ulti is down, but surely the ulti comes back up. And skill drain. Or maybe skill drain just sucks now. Forever. Skill drain can't suck forever,
right? It's not great in this format because, like, tier element shuffle stuff back and pop it, and then it doesn't matter.
Which, that's okay, but does skill drain ever come good again?
I mean, it's at 3, and I can't see it going back down anytime soon, so maybe it's not amazing anymore.
Effects on field are dead.
It's good against Sword Soul.
Until they bounce it with the Fish Shooter.
That, I guess, brings us to the end of our recap of our...
Yes, so yeah, that is basically the end of Player of the Year. But
the VOD's around, watch it. The commentary would have been shocking.
I'm looking forward to looking back on...
A lot of us whispering.
The crowd goes wild. See, I had the golf commentary thing going, because, yeah,
it would have felt weird. I suppose not. Like, it's definitely been a case where, like, you've been in a box commentating as opposed to, like, watching it live. Like, it's never the case where you're sitting next to it, because that would be dumb. But
his hand, he's open. He's opened this. He's got it. He's opened the key side deck card.
Yeah, sometimes there's been a couple of hype moments on the actual streams where it's like, oh, you didn't need to go that crazy, but you're doing it, you're going for it, okay, all right. I do prefer a bit more of a laid back, you're just filling the air. People watching, they know they're watching. All you're here to do is fill in side deck cards and some possible things that you might have noticed that they might not have picked up. So
yeah,
were there any interesting cards you saw from people's deck lists?
The anti-spell from Luke in the end.
Yeah.
Pretty clutch.
Yeah. Andrew's Econ is cute.
Yeah. I remember mentioning that a while back.
Yeah, like, I saw... It didn't actually even come up on any of the streams, though, so that was a bit sad. Most of the decks were pretty consistent. Like, well, that's the thing, but you look at it and go, it's a good deck. So, like, what do you do? Like, yeah, both the tier... all three of the tier decks were looking all right. You weren't running anything crazy. Except the Link.
Oh, my Agave that never came up. Well, it came up, but I didn't need it.
Yeah. I was like, well, we can't have a draw because it's doubly limb. You can't have draws.
Yep.
And I didn't know that first blood had been decided. I'm sitting next to the head judge. He's like, I don't know. I was like, he's going to have game here, but, like, you've really got to get on top of it, because if anyone else is drawn, this is going to throw a spanner in the works. But Jabe was here, so he would have seen that he, common sense prevailed, where he would have reminded. But, yeah, nothing too crazy, but...
So yeah, that does, I guess, recap us. And it's nice to sort of have that sort of little competitive thing before we get into like hard testing.
Yeah, now we're back to being friends.
That's the thing. Like, it wasn't like maybe Josh has some animosity, but everyone else was chill.
Yeah, this one was like, because we've definitely had lead-ins to Player of the Year events where people like to keep their secrets and stuff. And there was a couple of secrets. Oh, people weren't testing with each other yet.
Like, the only thing I changed about my deck from locals to the actual event was I had Twin Twisters in to deal with a lot of back row, but I knew that, like, the Exorcisted matchup wasn't there. So I was like, I don't care about the back row. I care about the monster effect. So I had Imperm.
There was one point, I think, was it against Josh on camera, where I had the Dragon's Ravine up, and I'm like, activate the Dragon's Ravine, discard, and he had to use his Twin Twist to pop it, and I was like, set the fucking Tidying, and look on his face when I did it, was like, oh, because I hadn't searched the Tidying, I'd drawn it for turn, I drew, and I'm like, activate this, discard an Ishizu card, and he's like, Twin Twist is pop it, and I was like, no problem, set up my regulation board, set one card, and he's like, oh.
I told you, Logan, Twin can work with Ravine.
Yep. It discards for cost. Of course it negates it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why would you think it did?
You pay the cost and it negates.
Anyway.
Judge.
Oh, no. He didn't question it. He was just like, I would put that in. I wouldn't bring it in that matchup. I'm like, he's got no other side deck cards. He's got three cards that's useless. And he's got a Ravine. You bring the Twin Twister in. Every day of the week. But what do I know?
So we move from our very small locals over to the OCG, where we have some news.
Yeah.
A little bit of news.
Little thing. So they've had their ban list come in. It's a big one.
Have we not done the ban list talk?
No. It happened hours after the podcast last time. So yeah, you're probably already aware of this, but we're going to discuss it.
Podcast, the ban lists keep dropping Monday morning, like recently. So,
cringe.
Unpleasant for us.
So, we start with Forbidden, Terelman Kikalos, and Barrier of the Wind Storms, whatever the fuck it's called.
We start off on we kill Terelman, then we also kind of move on. And we kill another good deck, because we're gonna fucking murder everything here.
Oh yeah,
this
the format's changing.
This is a reset button.
Yeah. God, I'm looking at some of this stuff and I completely forgot that it was here.
Yeah.
It's such a big list, it's so hard to forget.
It's huge. I thought this list was a joke.
I remember you said, like,
that's fake. And then I saw like another, and then like no YouTubers covered it, and I was like, see, it's fake as fuck. And then it just kind of turned out to be real.
Yep, here we are. So yeah, effectively, for the most part, the consistency, well, once we get to other cards, it'll be pretty clear that the consistency of Terelman is dead. Yes. But the OCG does still have grass. So, like, and snow and all the good stuff. So they can still run cards. It's just going to be...
curious.
I think so. Yeah, because they never did a danger build. So
is
I don't think they ever...
banned?
No.
There could be still ways to do Terelman stuff.
Yeah, like, it's not going to be the Terelman that you know. But at the same time... like, you just do it, right?
You're also kind of going to need to have, like, multiple Terelements engraved to just activate and resolve one.
You've got King of the Swamp and stuff that can replace Kikalos, and then you can still make Rukalos.
Still, that doesn't do that much.
I know, but yeah, it's an option. If people are dead set on playing it, it's not completely dead.
Yeah.
Moving on to the limits, we have a lot of these as well. So we have both Fenrir and Unicorn Kashtira to one.
Which is logical.
Makes sense. Shirin and Rhino Heart, both to one.
Mm-hmm.
We have...
I believe Merly and Havanas were already at one.
Yes.
Yeah.
One or two. One of the ones. So yeah, you've literally got one of each now.
Yeah.
Wow.
They have...
So they have none of three. None of the fuses are at three.
I think the field spell's limited as well, right?
Yes. I believe Planet is also at one.
So they've got... five cards limited and one card banned.
Highlander!
And people are still playing them.
Time to play 60 card Highlander mill deck.
We also have Satel and I Ptolemaeus following the TCG and following some news that we'll discuss briefly. Bestial Magnemut, also limited. Steam the Cloak, limited.
That came back.
Yeah, I think that one's coming back.
Yep.
Change of Heart, I think that one's also coming back.
Back.
Yep.
You're on that in side deck.
I did side deck.
Yeah, cards. That's the other cute card that was.
Oh yeah. I thought about it, but I didn't want to change too much.
I put it on in going second against Josh because I was like, oh, I'll take some. Yeah, fuck it.
Some Kashtira card that I can't make out and hasn't been released in the TCG yet, so I don't know what it is.
That's quick. That's their field spell, I think.
Oh, they got a field spell?
Yeah, yeah. That makes sense. Yeah, and because that has the...
It's the other triple P.
Yeah, and it adds the tier elements Kashtira as well.
Oh, okay.
So that's the other
one. I didn't realize they got a field spell as well. That's fucking bonkers.
Yeah, so they had two options to search for stuff. Oh, so that means the Kashtira tier as well is around, but it doesn't use, so...
I think it banishes in order to mill or something like that. Yeah, it's not super consistent. We also have Brain of Fusion to one. I don't know why they're... Well, I kind of know why they're...
What else is left?
they're intentionally trying to nuke everything.
Yeah, and I feel like this is semi-addressing Tier Element as well, because you can send a Tier Element off of Brain of Fusion part of the Rebellion package.
However, that does still probably give you, like, not enough to then make something else to fuse with.
Yeah. And finally, and I left this one till last, even though it was first on the list, Ancient Fairy Dragon with an errata.
With an errata that now says that you cannot search the field spell that you send.
Yes.
Is it the field spell that you send or either field spell that you send? Because if you're playing, like, Tier Element against your opponent, you send their triple P, can you search triple P?
Oh...
Yeah,
I don't imagine it's coming up as much anymore.
Well, that's the thing. Tier Element have two field spells, so it doesn't even matter.
But that means, does it keep its summon from hand?
Yeah, still has that.
So I mean, that was nearly the iffy part with that card.
No, it was the field spell. It was absolutely the field spell.
Yeah, it was the field spell.
Ancient Fairy Dragon has definitely been used for the other effect, though.
Oh, absolutely.
So that's why, like, if they're bringing it back, it's like, hold on, is there something else we've got to think about in future of like? Ah, crap, we errated like that effect, but we didn't fix the other effect.
Well, the other effect's also fairly restrictive, but it wasn't errated. It's the whole, like, no battle phase until you use it.
Yeah. Oh, no. I'm seeing if I can find the errata. It's
that's fine. It's not relevant.
Did I actually know for the semi-limits? We're in the limits. Okay.
Yep. So, that does conclude us for the limits, though. So we move on to semi-limits.
Yeah.
First off, we have Galatea, the Orcist Automaton, to two.
Congratulations.
This?
I'm very happy.
Oh my god. This. Yeah, here we go. Yep.
And makes me very happy. Swap Frog, to two.
Yeah, that's for us, I reckon.
Didn't it go down to two?
Yes. Yes, it did.
It went down to two.
No, limited to semi-limit.
Oh, was it at one?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought
it was... And they still banned Totally Awesome.
Yeah.
So that is a win for us. He's a win for Seb.
That's about the level of applause that it needs. For Seb we have Sky Striker Ace Kagari to two.
No clap. Oh, he hates it now.
Did it go down to two?
No, it goes up.
Up to two. It was limited. Because they've got two engage.
I thought they had three Ikari.
To two, we have Yatagarasu.
For no one.
I mean, Flunder could run it now as a little cute thing.
Flunder?
Yeah.
It's not a winged beast.
You small world it, Ben.
No, I think we looked at this. It's actually quite difficult to small world.
I don't think it is. No, you run the Earthbound Immortal.
I hate small world.
You run the Earthbound
Immortal. Yeah, I think it's because it's a
but
level
that's the thing. No, shut up. So, the Earthbound Immortal is also summonable within that deck. Because it's a winged beast that you tribute. And then it cycles cards from hand.
Weakukarashka.
Yeah, that one. Also, 7 limited, we have Rite of Aramisir.
To two.
Again, one of those cards that just seems benign over here.
I mean, okay, if Rite's going back to two, and they haven't banned the rest of the engine over there, no way OCG just isn't defaulting to adventure something.
Yeah, they'll switch back. We will regress.
Infernity Launcher, is it?
Yeah.
Yep. Back to two. Yep. Foolish Burial Goods to two.
Yeah.
2-2? Two, two?
Yeah, 2-2 two, two from Unlimited.
Rageki to two, which I think was Unlimited before,
yes,
right?
Yes, it was.
Yep.
Why? But why?
Lightning Storms.
Less destruction-y thingies.
Just put it to fucking one.
Well, they always used to be of the thing of like, no board wipes. Spell and Trap Destruction, though, you can have that.
You can have all of
heavy
that.
Heavy Storms at one.
Yeah. It's still so bonkers.
Yeah.
And Trickstar Light Stage to 2.
Dude, what's that giant Trunade at?
At Band.
Yeah, Trunade.
You know what
you do? Yeah. Hey, Trunade's legal. Giant Trunade.
Yeah, because Hey, Trunade is shit.
Hey, Trunade.
Actually, no. Hey, Giant Trunade 100% has to be banned anyway.
Oh, yeah.
I was wondering if like they're just so like they just don't care, like, they just don't give a fuck. They're like, oh, we got this, but we don't care.
I can't believe
that. Moving on to Unlimits, we have, for what feels like the 17th time, ABC Buster Dragon. This card just gets like the most strays on the ban list I've ever seen. Every so often it'll just be like, oh, we're limiting this, we're doing this, and then you one.
It goes to one. Firewall Dragon's doing really well. 8-1. Oh, we're putting A back to 1. As a precaution, ABC Dragon Buster banned.
It's so weird. I just obviously don't observe enough of what's happening in the OCG to know why this is such a yo-yo card.
When that deck first came out, it got bad in a hurry. Like, everyone over there was like,
yeah,
what if we play ABC? Like, over here, we were like, Metal Foes is cute, though. And Paleo's cute, though. Over there, they were like, what if we played ABC?
It was the same thing as Branded. It was that they all had it. It was really easy to get. They were just on that for so long. Lucky we didn't get that, but we got it a little.
We got it for, like, a couple weeks.
Did it win NYCS or Metal Foes?
No, Metal Foes won NYCS. It didn't even top cut. Like, it didn't make top 2.
Huh.
Yeah.
Is that the Blue Eyes? Is that the Andy Blue Eyes you?
Yep.
Yes.
Time flies when you're having fun.
Also, Unlimited, we have Double Iris Magician. Throw Pendies, another bone. Why not? Actually, in the OCG, they're doing fine. Like, they have.
It could legitimately be the best deck this format.
Potentially. Like, there was that brief time where Pendulum was just that in-between deck, but, like, when ban lists had just happened and formats hadn't been defined, where you just come in with a Pendulum Magician deck and just fucking dumps the people.
Now that I'm thinking about it, it's probably the best deck.
Here we go, March 1st, Limit Regulation, we'll have,
ABC Dragon Buster to 1. That is it.
And, an old mate, Electromite.
We also have Water Enchantress, coming back to 3. So, yeah, Adventure Package seems very much on.
Adventure ABC.
Yeah.
With Therian.
Yeah, seems natural.
Yeah, it's just the best deck in the OCG right now. That and Pendulum.
Yep. Taunt Scale is coming back to 3 as well.
Yeah, Adventure PK.
The other one, Adventure deck
back in the format.
Surely there's a card banned from that engine.
I don't know if there is.
What's the two other Albazar Jace types? You got Spriggans?
Spriggans, Tri-Brigade. And
so Tri's already hit there.
Dogmatica.
No.
Sword Soul is just their own little thing, isn't
it? No. Sword Soul is technically linked with Albas.
Oh, of course it is. It's got the guy, the Sword Soul guy.
Also has Ecclesia.
Iris.
Yeah, Incredible Ecclesia also summons Albas from deck.
Yeah.
Not that anyone ever uses that effect.
I completely forgot about that.
And Dogmatica. Yeah,
Dogmatica. Spriggans, I'm telling you. Spriggans is the next Albazar Jace deck.
They're getting new support.
So every Albaz card will be on the list at some point.
Eventually they'll just ban Albaz. Yeah. Maybe that's why they're making all these like specific laws around a specific monster, so that if ever they become a problem, they're just like, right,
ban it.
Even though if you banned Visa Starfrost, no one would know. No one would care.
What would happen if Visa and Albaz kiss?
Anyway.
Are they the same person?
No, they're different law lines, Ben.
Different haircuts too.
You sure?
Yeah, yes. One of them's a warrior, one of them's a dragon. One of them's light, one of them's dark.
Yeah, one of them goes to the planet messing up stuff, and the other guys are just all idiots.
I thought you said something else there.
Anyway.
No, because they got Albaz from the ground, and they're like, hey, you demon, you devil demon.
He came from the Nadir.
Yeah.
Anyway, finally, on the Unlimits, we have Scarlet Sanguine.
Oh yeah, I forgot about them.
What were they at? Were they at 2?
Or what? That was a 2.
Yeah. One would be too hard. We wouldn't be able to play it.
Let the record show that Seb gave a golf clap for this.
He did.
Yeah. Golden Lord's sick.
It'll be interesting to see how this all plays out. They have been doing a couple of like pre-banlist tournaments, and Tier Element is still seeing play for reasons I don't fully understand. Like, as much as it is playable. It's not a fun playable. Like, you would have to grind so hard to get to a fucking board.
Mm.
This Castiera hit is like hitting two cards instead of... What's the other one?
Spell card as well.
Oh, yes. Yeah, so that's like a very comprehensive rein-in, like, which we didn't see too often.
I personally don't think it was overly necessary. Like, yes, it would have been the best deck.
Yeah.
There is no question that it would have been the best deck.
Yeah, but they're cool.
But it didn't have a right to be the best deck. Like, it, at no point was it the best deck. They were just like, it's going to be... Buy something new, though, guys.
Yeah, I guess they've already sold the product that they need to, or they just don't operate that way.
Well, they don't, yeah, because they don't do mass reprint sets like us. They do, like, a reprint set of the cards you want, not the cards...
They also just print a nice number of the cards that you want within the main set.
Yeah,
so everyone has what they want from the beginning.
Their reprint sets are just like, oh, remember how we gave you that, like, super rare infinite impermanence when it came out? Here's the ultimate rare if you want it. Like, it's in there. Do you want it?
He's Rare Tree Toad.
Classic Tree Toad.
We miss you. Oh. We miss you every day.
Actually, since you brought him up, let's move over to some Master Duel news.
Oh, yeah!
So, there's a whole bunch of news that's been announced at the 2023 Jump Fest from Konami. But for Master Duel specifically, because a lot of it is Rush Duels, which I do not give
a fuck
about.
No new summoning condition, no new anime.
Yeah, yeah, none of that.
It's just
About Rush Duels was announced, but like, I don't give a fuck about
Again,
any of that.
I learned from our fucking comment section that they did release a new anime. It's just a different Rush Duels anime.
Yeah, it's 100 what? Years. What's Go Rush?
Yeah.
It's 100. I think it's 100 years post Sevens.
Why they continue anyway?
So Rush Duels is 100% their thing. I'm kind of after this week, and I want to kind of punch on with Rush Duels. But...
Moving to Master Duel, they've announced two main things that are happening at the moment. Obviously, we've got Duels Cup 2022 going. Upcoming, we have a new...
Is that worth me doing?
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm doing.
I've almost finished it. I've lost like one game. It's the only thing is, it just takes so long to play fucking matches with...
Yeah, maybe I shouldn't play Runic. I don't have time for that.
It's a time commitment.
I've got my testing.
Yeah, look, if you want low brain power but high time commitment, then yeah, Runic's your day.
Yeah.
Okay, so new solo mode that's coming out will be Mutant, which will be the third TCG exclusive archetype that has been made into a solo mode.
What was the other two? Sorry, and did it give us
Planet Patrol and Vendred?
Did it give us? So I actually should play the Vendred one. Did it tell
it's
us anything cool?
It's actually really fun.
Yeah, it was pretty interesting.
I actually really liked that one.
I did a video
one.
On it. Just watch that video.
Okay.
Yeah.
You don't need to play it.
I mean, you could play it.
Don't play it. We don't play solo modes here.
Yeah, that is my job.
Yeah.
And you
so
report
I'll report
back.
To you with the mutants.
Jake reports to us whether or not the solo modes were good, and then we just watch them on YouTube.
Start streaming your solo modes.
I don't know whether my laptop will support streaming. To
no,
be
how
honest.
About if you just screenshot the Discord, we'll figure out the logistics.
Yeah, and also, I still have that issue with my OBS studio that we hadn't sorted from like 8 months ago.
We'll talk logistics.
Yeah, next year. Also, we have a new mate that's joining us. Totally awesome. It actually looks a little bizarre, I'm not
makes
gonna lie.
Me kind of
yeah, those eyes are kind of dead.
I shed a tear. One tear for Tree Toad.
I look.
I suppose you're not going to be looking into the eyes. Like, if you look at where it is on the field, like, you're not going to be. It's not going to be like.
Look at
it's not going to be like that.
I want to see the animations for it. Like, that would be fun, I reckon, but I don't think it's replacing Ash anytime soon.
No. It won't replace my. It's the funniest thing. So I use Laundry Dragon Mate as my mate, the premium mate that transforms in the battle phase. Playing fucking Runic, so it doesn't transform.
You don't get a battle phase.
I don't get a battle phase.
Surely you just move on to Monolith or something. Just something.
No, it's still funny. She sits there and she's like, "Can I transform yet?" No.
No. We don't do that here.
We do not do that.
And finally, we have a upcoming selection pack, The Beginning of Turmoil. So it looks like stuff that we already have, to be honest. So we're getting Sinister Sovereign Keijing, which I think is the synchro that like banishes spells and monsters and burns for 12. another copy of Kyotis for reasons I don't fully understand. And some Ice Jade support.
What's with the 1200 burn? Is there something like in their... Yeah. Is there something in their own... Oh, the lore.
It's like the Jake number, except it's... Yeah, the Sword Soul number. 12.
But why did they choose 12, you reckon?
Because... I haven't looked into it.
If you add 12 to Jake's number, it becomes 100.
Dat math.
That's not my number. How dare you? That is not my number.
Probably because it can't go into 8,000.
Oh, it can. The burn for 12, Barone, the Link 1, Monk, and Qi Xiao is exactly 8,000.
No, I mean, but like,
you can't. You got 12 doesn't, 8, yeah, become 8. 12. I don't know.
Yeah, but you're not doing this multiple... Anyway. It's also getting Dynamorphia Rekstrom, which is the really good fusion for Dynamorphia, and some Gunk and Ship support.
Is it Dynamorphia Rectum?
No. Rex Term, actually.
Oh, I...
It's Rectum.
No.
Did Dynamorphia get their Power of the Elements cards yet?
Yeah.
Cool.
Oh, hang on. Maybe not. Maybe they're getting him in this.
Yeah, so because that's still missing the one trap. I think they're one more trap to go.
Yeah, so it's one more trap.
Then they're this full one. Power. Actually, Dynamorphia might do all right in OCG.
Is that like just like oh in OCG actually maybe yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe not, but
well, anything over there is worth a shot now.
I mean, yeah, pretty much. Time rules. I don't figure imagine, it out. Their time rules aren't as bad as ours, so they can play it.
Though there's also that remember that like firefighter archetype we got hyped on. This kind of did nothing. No, there was like a new one that came out like only a couple of weeks
ago. Yeah, it was Rescue Ace.
Yeah, we all just ignored it after it came out. Maybe that'll be good. Who knows?
I mean, they're getting other support as well.
Maybe that new Link to Sky Strike will do something.
Yes.
We also have the announcement of the Quarter Century Rarity Collection for the OCG. So they've announced some reprints. Nothing particularly outstanding in here is like, oh my god, that's an amazing reprint for 25 yeah. years. So like Fairy Tail Luna rather than Fairy Tail Snow. That's dumb.
It's simply because they do these reprint sets every year that are like every year they've been so fucking good. I think they're just out of good cards to reprint.
I mean, they're doing Rota, they're doing Reasoning, Spell yeah. Good Judgment, Chaos Space.
Like, in years past they've been like, here's Ash Blossom, here's Imperm. He's like all of these staples. That I think they've just.
Actually, I think
point
they did.
Just...
I think I saw another thing earlier today that they are doing Ash as well.
Oh yeah, but
so,
like
yeah,
I think they've just hit a point where they've just done so many of these reprint sets that are so good that now it's like.
Oh no! What a problem to have
yeah,
in the OCG. We've run out of good things to reprint.
It's astounding that they're just like. He's like, it's the 25th anniversary. We apologize. We want it to be really good, but we've just kind of been giving you so much good shit that this is all we
so it's
left.
Just kind of mid.
Like their 20th anniversary one was insane. Where that was the one where like it was Maxi in every rarity, Ash Blossom in every rarity, and now it's just like, sorry, but this is what we've got left.
I can tell that you've either been talking or talking all day or all night because your voice is slipping.
No, my voice has been gone like for the past like 3 days. So.
I haven't noticed.
He's
until
been
now.
Yelling in the house. He's been abusing us.
Yeah. I come home from work and I'm like,
be quiet, I'm trying to test.
I need to normal summon chamber.
We also have an announcement of the next piece of Visa Starfrost lore, the new archetype, which is called Mana Dome. It's a synchro, obviously, because we've had Link, we've had Fusion, we've had Xyz. So now we move on to synchro.
But we already had Sword Soul.
Different lore line, Ben.
No, it's
different
all,
lore line, Ben.
It's all the same lore.
It isn't. We just went.
Oh yeah,
through
that's
this.
A good point. So we go back to this. Yeah. All. Yeah.
Yeah. So we've got one more line of the Albaz, and then that's done. That'll be that story done. This is like midway through.
Yeah, I never thought. Yeah, I never really thought that. Yeah, the Talonites are still going with.
Talonites.
Oh, I thought we moved on to Talonites already.
No.
When does Vista Starfrost get to move into the Burning Abyss and make out with Dante Pilgrim?
Are you okay?
Oh my god, yeah, good point.
Yeah.
Augie, Visa.
Augie in the Burning Abyss.
Albaz,
anyway,
Dante.
That's going to be a great level 8 Burning Abyss monster.
And Constella Diamond.
So, the interesting thing about this archetype so far is that it's central synchro. doesn't need non-tuners.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Oh, yeah, you told me about this.
I did.
I have forgot it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
because you are rude.
Yeah, and you can use multiple tuners in the other side of it, too.
Yeah.
So you just go monsters there. It's just a Link monster.
Yeah, basically. They just made a white Link monster. Like, it's not got any impressive effects. Like, it can attack up to a number of times that it has tuners as material. That's sort of why they gave it the non-tuner, non-restriction.
Yeah.
Well, because I didn't even realize that the second half of it was, like, could be used as a tuners. I'm like, oh, sweet. So you just do three tuners into the one non-tuner, that you get the three attacks. But no, if you do the three non-tuners.
Like, it is restrictive in some respects in that you have to use the lighter tuners, but you've got Visa Starfrost, the ones that are in the archetype, which are just kind of free. Like, when they're destroyed, they summon another copy of themselves from deck, and then the field spell, when one's destroyed, summons another copy of them from deck,
yeah.
And then they've got cards that are recycled. Like, it's just kind of free. And it's generic as well. Like, you don't have to summon that. You can summon heaps of other synchros.
Yeah.
And again, just the way that the lore works, it sort of interacts obviously with Visas, but it also interacts with the other like heart monsters, the main deck heart monsters, because
yep.
It needs either Visa Starfrost specifically,
yep,
or a monster with 1500 attack and 2100 defense. And I was like, oh, I wonder how many monsters have that stat line.
It's like none. Yeah.
Just the hearts and one dub Zen mating,
yeah.
Or Zen main, sorry.
Yeah.
The like, if it gets destroyed, detach one instead.
Oh, is that why someone said Zen Man's the other day?
Yeah, because yeah. Leroy, we're having a discussion.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'm like, what a weird pull. Okay.
So yeah, it'll be interesting to see if that archetype actually does a lot. It just depends, I guess, on how generic it is. I have seen some kind of boards that they can do where, like, you set up a Barone, you set up an Appaloosa.
Again, OCG can be whatever it wants right now.
Yeah, true.
OCG is like a bright-eyed 12-year-old who's just gone to high school and you're like, you can be anything you want, except for something successful.
Except for Tyrilement.
Now, don't get in that mech suit.
Oh no, they're going to get in the mech suit. They're all just going to get in the mech suit.
Everyone turned into mech suit.
Oh
no.
We also have the announcement. Sky Striker. Please no. We also have the announcement of the new Teller Knight support, or
so, yeah.
Constellar.
Yeah, so that's another, like, we've got so many plots now. And I guess that's why they don't need
this. Isn't really a plot, it's just archetype support.
Is that why
Petulia No, Teller Knight's in a plot line.
Yeah, it's in a plot line with Shadol's.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, but, like, Shadol's got support, and it wasn't, like, a continuation of their lord. Necroz got support. Like, this
now
shit just comes
now,
across every
now
so
Now they're
often.
Animalists, there's no way there's not a plot for this now.
There isn't.
Alright.
Until they actually do, like, a Arcane-style series of this shit,
well,
it's
mean,
just a random throwaway support.
It was like the Sky Striker manga.
I just had an idea of what I want to do for my birthday. So, hear me out. Ben's birthday soon. Friday Night Drinks.
Yes.
I'm just going to put on a random Season 1 Yu-Gi-Oh! Episode, and you got to take a drink every time Yugi mentions his grandpa.
Mm-hmm.
The rules of the game are broken,
mm-hmm.
or a card that doesn't exist is played.
Well, the rules of the game, well, it depends on how you define the rules of the game. They're pretty...
I hope it's a very short duel, because, like, if they make a if there's one misplay, there's seven.
No duels in Season 1 are short.
My field battle is advantage. That's a drink.
But that was the whole... Yeah.
Field advantage, that's a drink.
Look,
I've attacked
I'm
the ring
here,
around your castle, not the castle.
That's a drink.
That's a drink.
That's a drink.
That's a drink.
No tribute summon? That's a
My
drink.
Monster's hiding under the water. Oh,
that's
a skull. Look, I could be on board for this, but make sure I eat first, because otherwise I'll be fucking wasted.
Yeah. It sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, dust is good for Ben. But anyway, back to Satellas. So the support's actually really solid. Like, one's a spell and trap search. One's an extender if another one's summoned. One can cheat out the Xyz. Like, yeah. It's just really solid support. So I'm actually looking forward... Well, actually, I would say I'm looking forward to it, but I also don't want to regress to a point where I'm getting fucking... what's the fucking Alpha Nova? Is
yeah,
that the...
Yeah. Nova draw one.
Yeah. Because that's
Ashable?
Not once per turn, is it?
It's a counter trap.
It's a counter trap. It's
yeah.
very much not Ashable.
Teller Knights fight Necroz.
in the lore. It's in the.
Is there a triangle?
Alpha.
No. Diamond.
Yeah.
Triangle.
Yeah.
Is there three archetypes that in the triangle?
Necroz, Evil Swarm, Stella.
That makes sense. Yeah. That checks out.
Yeah, because they punch on with the Evil Swarm, then the Evil Swarm nick a few of them. And then, just somehow later, the Telemites then fight the...
Jake's looking up the trivia.
I am. So, it looks like the Yangzings give them their power.
Yangzings are in this?
And they confront the Shadols, in actuality.
Yeah.
You're in the wrong
lore line. We discussed this at the start.
Wait, Telenite or Constellar?
Telenite.
Sorry, Constellar.
Yeah.
Well, this is support for both.
Yes. So there's two plot lines, and Jake doesn't fucking acknowledge it.
Yeah, but who cares about the Constellars?
Who cares about the past?
The Constellars are shit. This support might make them okay, but that's it.
Yeah, the Constellars were pretty bad.
They were very bad.
Back to his roots.
Shadol roots?
Wait, his roots were Blue Eyes, wasn't it?
No, I thought he was playing Teller before that.
I thought it was Blue Eyes then Teller, wasn't it?
No, it was or Teller was it then Blue both? Eyes.
Oh, yeah, maybe. But Teller was Josh. Yeah,
we need accurate Josh lore.
Yeah, no, he went from Blue Eyes to Salad. Because the YCS before Salad came out was when I played him. And
Yeah. Because I remember giving him Blue Eyes, like upgraded Blue Eyes rarity cards, which clearly he doesn't remember because he fucking hates me for reasons I don't understand.
He dislikes me. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yes, the other day, where he has a secret.
Oh, yeah, that was dumb.
He has a secret?
Yeah, he has a secret.
He has one of my secrets.
We don't know what the secret is.
I feel like he was just alluding to other shit.
He's just saying a word.
Yeah, there is that too.
We better go in the comments. You got any more content?
No, there's a lot of news.
There's heaps of stuff we can unpack.
But this is the last podcast of the year. There's a lot to cover.
Yeah. So also in Cyberstorm Access, we have further support for the Sulfur Chords. Pendulum Women.
Okay, well, I missed this.
I don't know how.
Sorry. I thought we were...
Lachlan posted this in chat specifically, because he's like, Pendulum, let's go!
Oh.
Boo.
Did I miss it?
So.
Boo.
Semi-generic materials, 2+ monsters, including a pendulum, so you can use into the... beyond the pendulum, sorry, and one other pendulum monster. Simples.
I thought 9 months ago we said you weren't allowed to read these.
I'm just getting to the good stuff.
Stiff. He likes them. The Jaker likes them.
Freudian slip. but the main thing that it's got going for it is it's actually got a negate.
Oh, it negates?
Yeah. So if opponent activates a card or effect, special summon a Sulfur Chord with an odd pendulum from your pendulum zone to the card zone this card points to. And if you do negate the activation, then you can add a Sulfur Core Pendulum monster with an even scale from deck to extra deck.
Were they announcing these at Jump Fest?
Yeah.
So they're just up here going, and this card, and this card. Now the two voice actors are going to fight each other. Oh, did you want any more news? We got some more cards.
More Rust.
And this card.
The other thing it does as well is that anything that's summoned to its link arrows can't be negated, or pendulum monsters anyway. So, again, it's decent. It's a decent bit of support.
Sure.
They've also got a spell card, but it needs far too many things going on for it to actually be relevant. There's a random spirit monster, which is shit, so I'm definitely not reading that. There was a... what was it? An elemental hero and armed dragon fusion monster, but that was also
cards
shit.
Search spirit cards.
No.
Then it's shit.
Yes.
That was a search charter. Shit.
It was Neos and armed dragon.
That Neos armed dragon's not that bad.
It's not that great.
Yeah, it's not.
It looked cool.
The person that I watched unveil it.
Oh, I know why you fucking like it. Because it doesn't care about what dragon it brings back from the graveyard. Dragon maiden.
No, that wasn't my logic. My logic was I would never fucking play this card in a million years.
I just thought
it was cute that like the fusion uses the armed dragon, and the bigger armed dragon you send, the more you get to pop. I thought that was cute. The person I watched unveil this was like, you can send armed dragon level 7, and I was like, armed dragon level 10 exists, buddy.
There's two armed dragon level 10s.
Yes.
And we'll probably get another one, right? We'll get a water one, a moisty one.
No.
Wet
not
dragon
that.
Level 10.
Stop.
Stiff dragon level.
Stop. 10. But yeah, you could potentially summon this off Neos Fusion. and do Dragon Maid nonsense.
In the lore, does it go stiff dragon level 10 and then
stop
dragon
stop,
level 10?
Stop, stop, stop.
And then
stop,
waste dragon
stop,
level 10?
Stop.
No, you need the arm to go the stiff.
No, I think you need, once it's stiff, you need to arm it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
And then level up.
All right. I'm going to move on to questions now.
Oh, yeah. So, but anyway, so in there, no anime no new anime announcement,
yep.
Obviously, because Rush Jewels is its own thing. It's got its own market. It's off there. Whether or not we ever get an English, I don't think it's neither here nor there.
I
but they've got a... They're still writing storylines. They've got the manga. Like, is there going to be another anime? Like, they have to think of something. Is the way it's peddling on, it's losing marketing value. Because they're funneling kids into sevens.
But there's nothing to sell them.
Like...
Not in the...
Especially
TCG market.
Yeah.
But over there, like, it's so... If they switch to sevens, the main... I'm kind of not afraid for the main game, but it's like, oh, are we going to be starting to lose support in the OCG?
And if anything, I feel like this year we had more... This last year, we had more individual product releases, I think, than any other year. But part of me thinks that I'm only thinking that way because the first half of the year was probably pretty barren and a lot of it's got delayed to the second half of the year. So it seemed like a lot's been coming. Maybe it's because all the good stuff has come at the end of the year as well. There was good stuff at the start of the year. But like when it's, 4 months between getting fucking Adventure to Branded and then it's like 2 weeks from getting like one thing to the next thing to the next thing. All of it is good.
Yeah, it was like Darkwing Blast, then... Cheesy Fairies, then Crystal Beasts.
Then Battles of Legend.
Yeah,
Battles of Legend. Yeah, there was
then
definitely there was definitely like a big run of product towards this end of part of the year.
So yeah, it's that thing of why they probably need a game plan to keep not adults hooked, but like on the main game, or whether or not they have a plan for Rush Jewels to progress into Master Jewel. Is another question. Sorry, Master...
Speed
Duel. Current rule.
Surely they don't. Or at least if they do, it'll be like a Speed Duels level thing.
I'm
where
actually
they'll...
really fucking curious to watch like episode one of the second Rush Duel anime. Because like, Rush Duels itself, I'm fairly sure, was just because the fucking main protagonist was like, I like to break the rules. Normal summon.
Yeah.
And it's like 100 years later of that kid normal summoning, everyone else is like, normal summon. Draw 5, yeah.
Cross Jewels is kind of that same similar rule set, right?
Oh, there was a Cross Jewels live stream. No one watched it.
We talked about this last week,
and no one acknowledged us talking about.
I thought it was a Jump Fest as well, but no. There was dueling stuff in there too. My God, it's just they're all over the shop, and the main game seems to be
Firewall Dragons coming out in Duel Links.
It is
those pots. They're doing the little pot collection.
I saw that a couple months ago. That actually looks really cool. I actually really want it.
I don't think if you're able to drink from them, but if you could, they'd be cool little shot glasses.
I think they're like a decent size though, aren't they?
No, they're like this big.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, the ones I saw, I swear, were like to scale, like a pot
oh,
size.
Oh, yeah, so that was they only did like Pot of Greed though.
No, I saw like an entire collection.
Oh, well, the entire collection ones. Like.
So Jacob saw this, but Ben saw this. Interesting perspectives. Do you have questions?
I have a few questions. So, if you weren't aware, we do have a Discord link. Will be in the description below. It keeps taking me.
This is going to be kind of a weird time in terms of questions for the rest of the year because this is the last podcast for the year. We're going to be off for 3 weeks, and then the return podcast will be a post YCS podcast. So, I don't know how that's going to kind of go. But we'll figure it out.
Feel free to ask your questions, but yeah, just keep in mind that until after YCS, we may not get to them in a recording anyway.
Yeah.
If there's any pertinent questions, feel free to let us know that you need an answer, but that's more the general chat anyway.
Yeah, so middle Jan is our next normal episode, but...
Yes. Yeah. So, first question this week comes to us from Oracle. How far have you come in the game since you first started/returned to the game? In your collection, in your skills, etc.
I am a significantly better person now than I was when I returned to the game. No, I'm better in every way. I am a superior person in every way. Except I had two working knees when I came back to the game, but I lost one pretty quickly. I returned to the game 6 months later. I lost the leg, and it was like, Oh, okay.
Who did?
Yeah, no. When I returned to the game, I was like, is said Big Shield Gardener still good? It was not. I got Pendulum Summoned on and like full fucking Pepe comboed, and I was like, that didn't work.
But yeah, I mean, you have grown.
Yes.
I think all three of us can probably still do more growing as well. We all haven't got a YCS top.
No.
That's probably the goal.
One day.
It would be nice.
My Dragon Mains will get me there this year. Definitely. If I make day two, I'll be happy.
Yeah, same.
I'm still in this, especially after last YCS. Yeah, because yeah, I'd been day two every single time except the last one, and that really fucking irked me.
I still to this day do not know how I day two'd the YCS with Exodia.
You got to day two?
I made it to day two.
Bruh.
I won like my last six rounds.
Oh, so after me, it was just all the way up.
Yeah, I won every game after a match. I still to this day do not know how the fuck that happened. I didn't know I made day two. I just didn't show up.
Oh, you just didn't go? Oh,
yeah.
God.
I didn't know. And then in the morning, I like checked pairings and I had a pairing and I was like, oh, I already said I wasn't going over there today. Oh, well.
Excuse me.
We're all dying.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, so
well,
when I returned to the game, like there was definitely stages. First, it was just like playing with mates at like a kitchen table on a Tuesday, and then one of us found good games, so I started going there as like, oh yeah, I could compete. I couldn't. There was a vast difference in skill points, and that's where like there was definitely a combination of like time and disposable income. I was buying really terrible product and trying to make it good. I was playing some egregious decks. I was playing some absolutely hideous decks. Fucking Ghost Trick, Skeleton Mill, fucking Gradles. What were the other garbage things I was playing? I played a lot of garbage.
Mine was I after getting full Pepe comboed, I was like, I'm gonna build whatever this pendle is. And then, like, as I was building it, shit was getting banned, and I was like, why is this not good? Right. It was really good when I got it played against me. That was, like, 3 months ago.
I can't remember what the turning point was. I think it was maybe the announcement of YCS, the very first YCS before, like, the one that you and I went to and versed, that was where I sort of found that competitive drive, because at that point, I was like, look, what deck should I play? And everyone's like, oh, look, you can play any of these decks. This Mermail deck is like a decent OTK deck. It just got support. So I was like, this looks all right. I ended up buying like most of it core online, and then like got the rest of it together. And it did fine. Like I was playing Mermail OTK all the way up until Invoke got released. And it was...
That's a fucked timeline. Or was that only like 2 weeks?
No. That was a while. Invoke got released mid-year.
No, it didn't. It got released in February.
No, it didn't.
Yes, it did.
Did it?
It came out last week of February. Because we got Zodiac on the February, like... I think we got Zodiac on Valentine's Day. And then on the 28th, we got...
Was that Invoke Summoners?
Yeah.
It felt longer than that. No. It feels like I shouldn't have...
2 weeks before that, we got DDD.
Oh yeah, I bought DDD, but I never played it.
I bought DDD and was like, oh, I just need to get a Crystal Wing. And then Zoo came out and I was like, where goes this? Bragg's researching it, even though I'm right. I have an eidetic memory, Bragg. I'm right.
I'm searching, I'm curious.
Boo. But yeah, then
my played... dates might be like 2-3 days off, but I can't read text.
Then bought Evoked, and that's been with me. I sold it for a bit. When Master Rule 4 came out and the pointy zones made it too difficult to do the Wind Witch combo specifically.
Ah, yes. Wind Witches.
They were fun.
That was the dumbest fucking deck I've ever played. It was that year's LLDS. I think I came last. Because it was one of those things where... back then, I would go to tournaments and I'd just be like, what if I just put, like, a little bit of everything good in a deck and just see what happens? So I played, like, Wind Witch, True Draco, Dino, That there was something else thrown in there.
Awful.
Because, like, everything had been hit on the ban list, too.
Yeah.
And I was just waiting for Spiral. So I was like, just threw all of this shit into one day. And I had those invoked in there as well. And it was Link format had just started. And I was like, this does not work at all.
What did I play? Wait, which LLDS was that?
That was end of 2017.
I don't think I ever got to play in that series of LLDS.
I'd also just died. That was when I had my virus.
Oh, your thing. Yeah.
My disorder. So I like came out of that and was like, fuck it. There are four decks in here. And it did not work out.
But yeah, there's definitely been like a gradual increase. And then I had, I think it was 2019, was like my best run in terms of competitive play with the Good Games Store Championship series. That's so far my crowning moment, but there's more moments to come.
I thought that was 2018 as well. Was it not? Or was that a year after that?
Oh, maybe it was 2018. Yeah, it was 2018.
I thought that was also that like brief period before Spiral. No? Or was it a year later?
No, because I was playing Orcus and Thunder Dragon at that point.
Yeah, it would have been a year later then.
Yeah.
So what I wanted to lock on with the timeline of Zoo into Invoked is that's where the Fusion Sub reprint was in there. So we were all swimming in Super Fusion Subs for bullshit. That's why I'm like, I think he's 100% right. Because, those Fusion Sub reprints. Whenever I stopped playing Scraps. There's like, I actually didn't have that bad of decks before that, but I hyper-focused on Scraps and I really wanted to make them work. And I think as at least for at least a year and a half. And I don't remember what I pivoted into, but then I just ended up going, oh, I guess I'll play meta. And then I just fell in love with the meta instead.
I think my turning point was after that YCS where we played our shit decks. And then Zoo format going into when I got Paleo. Me getting totally awesome was the point where I became a good player. And then when I became like a proper, I'm going to take this seriously player was Spiral, which was the end of that year. And I killed the locals playing Spiral.
You did. Because you were like the only one going down there at that point.
No, everyone was going. Just I was the only one that had Spiral. So I was like, we were playing 4-round locals and I was winning them in 2 hours. I was just like, Spiral combo, I won. Spiral combo, I won. Spiral combo, I won. And everyone stopped playing.
Thank God no one quit after Dragon Rollers or else Good Games would be rough.
I think in terms of like a turning point, I think for me it was like maybe at Colossus? Yeah, Thunder Dragons I think was like the point where I was like, okay, like I've got, this is the deck that I want to...
Also, just disposable income. That was probably the biggest shift as well. It's like, I was kind of forced into a corner of like, I guess I'm playing this because I don't have...
I was in this weird situation when I started playing where I had disposable income, but I couldn't play the game. Because that was when I was a truck driver. So I was like, working late nights and I was also working weekends. So like, I'd work 3 days away Tuesday to Thursday and then I'd work Saturday, Sunday. So I just never ever was home for when any locals ever ran. And it was like, if I just didn't have a load that day, I'd be like, fucking good locals, let's go.
He did bring up collections as well. As I stated before, there was definitely a point in my starting of Yu-Gi-Oh! Where I bought a lot of trash product where, looking back on it, I wish I hadn't. Like, that money could have been so better served. But collection these days isn't looking too bad.
Over there costs $25 each.
What?
Syndicate collection sitting in the corner, $25 each.
What does?
It's the syndicate stuff. Costs $25 each.
Oh, like what it started with. Yeah.
Yeah, and it's now like 4 fucking of those giant card boxes, like 8 binders, some Starlight Rares, some ultis.
Yeah, a couple of ghosts.
Yeah, just chilling.
Yeah. That collection's doing well, and then like my own personal collection, it took a hit last year when I was like running out of money. I had to sell a lot of like the collector's rares and ultis and stuff that I had, but it's building back up now. It's more in staple cards that a lot of my sort of more high rarity stuff is now, like ulti droplets, ulti Nibirus, ulti cosmics.
I forgot I have my the 2018 Worlds cards on the wall.
Oh, you still got those? Yeah.
I'll sell those one day.
I wish I'd kept.
Open to offers. Starting bid's $10,000.
Is that really what they go for?
No, they go for like 6 or 7. If someone offers me 10, I'll consider it.
Yeah, for sure.
They're framed.
I wish I'd kept the prize card that I bought. I wish I'd kept it. But again, I'm bad with money.
Yeah. I want a giant card.
It's alright, we'll get one.
We'll buy the one this
year. We'll get one for you, Ben.
Syndicate will buy this year's prize card.
He's cucks buying giant.
Try out Midas.
I tried to win one. Raph never fucked me.
And then we bought it.
That was so rough.
Well, technically, we didn't buy it. People at our locals bought it. We're buying the one this year. Yeah. If people from our locals are trying to buy it, we'll be like, fuck you.
You understand? We're buying it. You understand that Tom will absolutely do that, right?
He's gonna try to snake us, and I'll be like, fuck you.
Yeah, I wanted all in on the RAF one, where it's like, hey, no, I want this all to be an ownership, but they took that away. But so let's sort a consortium out. Let's do it.
Syndicate owns it, mate.
Yeah, we kind of already have a consortium.
Another consortium. All right. Oh, I won't bid on the same one because there's multiple. So maybe we just chase different
multiple.
Ones. We'll get two. There'll be a speed duel one.
I'm sorry, there will absolutely not. We're not getting coverage, Bragg. It's either
none or two.
I've conceded we're getting none.
Yeah, none or two. I will not be surprised when none.
One is so disappointed.
But they have so many. They would have so many lying around from all the missed events, as if they just don't go. Let's get them out of here.
That's the thing. That would be the case if we were in Europe or America. But they're not going to be laying around here because they're not bringing them here.
Yeah, true. So they'll just have they'll just ship the boxes. And do we even get entry packs this time? I don't know anymore.
We're paying $25, getting a mat.
I honestly think we're paying $10 to $25 and getting a kick in the nuts. I'm pretty sure we're getting.
I'm going to pay $25 to get COVID.
Oh, yeah, true.
Maybe you will.
But yeah, I have very low expectations of what they'll actually give us for this YCS. By all means, if I get proven wrong, that's great. But I'm going in there with
I just
very
want an entry map, man.
Fucking basement level expectations.
I just want a fucking entry map.
They're not going to do the.
They're not doing entry map.
I know. They'll never do it again.
They're not doing that because everyone's bought tickets. Without hassle, so they have
fucking ridge on lion.
Yeah,
there's no lion, so no pre-ridge dice.
Oh, ugh. Yeah, it's the dice and your blue dice is in one of the VODs from this year, by the way.
Is that where that was?
No, it's in one of the VODs. It's there on the table.
Yeah, I know. I know when it went missing. I know exactly when it went missing.
Mr. Co-commentator.
I know the day it went missing specifically.
I do miss the dice. Anymore. The dice and the playmats is what it's all about, not random packs. And I really kind of hope they get back to it one day. They won't unless if there's a big change and they don't sell out based on shitty pricing. I guess it's our fault for buying tickets.
We've gone on a long rant based on this one question.
Yes.
Next question.
Next question comes to us from Ryguy.
I'm just running his voice dead.
It's gone.
We want Ben to shut up.
I got to work tomorrow. I got to talk. Talk for a living.
Talking's overrated. Question from Ryguy is, do you think that the format you start playing in affects how you see you go after that? Yeah.
Really?
I would think so.
I don't remember the format.
And if maybe not the format, definitely the deck you start with, I think shapes what player you end up as.
If it was like that for me, when I came back into the game?
Mm-hmm.
No, because then I'd just be still playing fucking. I'd be the guy in the corner going, Yu-Gi-Oh's not like the anime anymore. Why is it not like season one?
I reckon it's the deck you got good with. Because for me, that was
true. Dragon. Yeah, that's true. Seb's statement is true that it's the deck you got good with shapes you as a person.
No, I'd agree with that.
So.
I'm totally awesome! I just want to make it with Ronan Totem!
I do have a preference for control decks, but at the same time, if I have to combo, I have to combo.
Remember 6 months ago when I won locals with Paleo and times were good and I could make Ronan Toten?
I get the sentiment. A lot of people are like that. That's just not how I operate. I like Tyr. And I'll move on. I like all of them.
So sad. I'm going through heartbreak.
I like Graffa.
You like Graffa? I don't want to make
Dense.
Did I ever mention me playing Dark World on the podcast, or did this just happen and then I didn't talk?
What's this?
Oh, when I was like last.
Oh, time. You've not mentioned that you transitioned.
Yeah. Oh, cool.
You're playing Dark World.
No, I'm not.
No, he's definitely ready. He started playing it. Stop playing it.
Yeah. Look. It was a good 2 days.
It's potentially going to be cute.
Yeah, it was a good 2 days.
He was like, what are you going to do when I loop you for four?
I'm looping for four.
And he stopped.
Yeah, and then I'm like, oh, this bricks so much.
Next question comes to us from... hang on. Sorry, there's a sea of stuff that is in questions yet again.
Yeah, I see a lot of your name there. Fill in the...
Yeah. That's because I was replying to Oracle because we missed his question.
He's skipping over my quotes, I'm pretty sure.
I've got your question here.
Half an hour on Oracle's question.
And your question...
You've learned Oracle. It was a good question.
It was. I have a question from Bragg. Why doesn't Jake have better eye?
Eye is in AI adding mister.
They're already at their peak. They're doing
well,
great.
You played a Cybers deck.
I did.
Yeah, see, like that hasn't influenced you. You pick up different stuff, even though you...
I just play the stuff I like. I've said this for ages. If there's a mechanic or like a deck theme that I enjoy, I play it. And like Ignista, when it first came out, was cool, but it wasn't good. Like, it was geared towards a going second deck, and I don't remember if Access Code was out at that point. Was Access Code out before Ignista? Surely. Maybe not. No, it wasn't. No, because it came out.
Weren't they both in Eternity Code?
No, Ignista was in
Lightning Storm set. That is Ignition Assault that came out in February.
Yeah. Oh, and that was before COVID, yeah?
Yeah. That was a pre-COVID set.
So yeah, it didn't really have much going for it other than like Spell Trap and Monster Removal. It really couldn't push for like big damage unless you like cheesed it with some other shit.
Remember?
What's another deck? What's another deck that I've played?
I'm confused by
see him dodging the eye question?
I said why, because my fucking genetics.
Oh, see, I didn't hear.
I'm
next
fucking,
question for next week. Sorry, next month.
Short-sighted. I've got an astigmatism in my left eye, and I'm red-green color deficient.
What?
Man, Christmas is hell for Jake.
Oh, yeah. Santa, where are you?
Wait, he doesn't wear green.
He wears red.
Yeah, red. I thought you said red and green.
Yeah, that both problems cause me a problem.
He can't see Santa or the elves.
Ah, damn.
You they don't have to be together to cause me issues. Both colors cause me problems.
Oh.
Anyway, next question comes to us from Crobat5.
Five.
Yes.
V.
No. If Konami wants to unban grass, they won't. On the next ban list, what would your reaction be, and would it change the format? My reaction would be, what the fuck is happening, Maria? The format would kind of regress into sort of what it was around Zoo time.
Yeah, that Infernoid mill, then Altergeist was grassing for a bit too, yeah.
Altergeist?
The Altergeist format had grass running around as well, yeah.
Was that Logan?
Oh, the format did, but like Altergeist wasn't.
Yeah. No, but like in that format, grass was running around.
Randomly, I just want to raise this. I played against Infernoid in Master Duel the other day. I flipped Deck and BMD one. He reasoned. I called one. He milled a bunch of cards. He hit his Decatron. Then he summoned something, and under Deck and BMD one, he could still Monster Gate. So he like summoned his second Decatron. I negated it. And then he monster gated it away, and then like the third last card in his deck was his third Decatron, and then I got rid of that as well, and then just milled out the last three cards of his deck, removing it, and I was like, I popped it. Oh, he had no targeting deck to send for the effect, and then I popped it and milled the last three cards in his deck, and I was like, good.
Don't they have a spell? Don't they have the nuke?
Yeah, they do. He didn't use it.
Well, he couldn't get on the board. The deck immediately one was there.
Oh, yeah, true. Yeah, he kept locking himself
into the Decatron. Yeah, couldn't send it to turn itself into it.
He needed to link the Decatron off into like a Linkaribo.
Yeah, instead I just removed the Decatron.
Yeah.
I don't think I would enjoy a format with grass, especially if it's still tier as it is. That would be problematic. Yeah. Not keen for that to happen, ever.
Yeah, the Ishizu stuff will just start, like, would probably do some silly shit as well.
Yeah. Like, you could just run every graveyard extension card known
to me. Put grass back!
We already have people like that are like T Relev is busted, yeah, you put, and then they were just like, oh, we've heard you, we understand your issues, grass to three.
To be fair, it's at 2 in the OCG and they stopped playing it.
Yeah.
They all went to 40 cards because it was more efficient.
Good.
Well, yeah, if your opponent's like searching 10 cards, like you get to mill some anyway. Mm. It's fine. Mm. It's okay. That does conclude us though. Thank you all very much for what. Yeah, we didn't get a lot of questions to be honest. Thank you all very much. Unless I've missed them again. Thank you all very much for watching. As we've stated before, this will be our last sort of live-ish podcast. The other ones will be sort of formatted differently, so we won't be doing question times. But as stated, feel free to jump into the Discord. If you do have any moments of 2022, please give us the timestamp. We will be compiling something really soon for that, so please get your entries in, just so we can find a put hashtag C4G 2022. Just makes it a little bit easier to find. But otherwise, thank you all very much for watching, and we will catch you again next year.
Yep. Have a Merry Christmas, Happy New Year's. Hanukkah's today, so Happy Hanukkah.
Is it?
Yeah. So, yeah, all that stuff.
See you. New Year's.